invite you to rise and join in song.
We walk by faith and not by sight. No gracious words we hear from him who spoke as none are spoke, but we believe him here. We may not touch his hands and sigh, nor follow where he trod, but in his promise we rejoice and cry, my Lord and God.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
We're challenged to walk by the faith of our Lord, and at times we know that we fail to do that. We turn and we sin, and so we pause to seek his mercy and forgiveness, to again walk in faith with our Lord. Lord Jesus, you call us to follow you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you bring us redemption. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you show us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Today the church celebrates Pope Callistus I, Pope and Martyr. He began as a slave in his life, he was sold into slavery, worked his way out of that, all the way up to being Pope. O God, who raised up Pope St. Callistus I to serve the Church and attend devoutly to Christ's faithful departed, strengthen us, we pray, by his witness to the faith, so that rescued from the slavery of corruption, we may merit an incorruptible inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever. First reading, we listen for the contrast between the sins of the flesh and the fruits of the Spirit.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, if you are guided by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are obvious. Immorality, impurity, licentiousness, idolatry, sorcery, hatreds, rivalry, jealousy, outbursts of fury, acts of selfishness, dissensions, factions, occasions of envy, drinking bouts, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. In contrast, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such, there is no law. Now those who belong to Christ Jesus have crucified their flesh with its passions and desires. If we live in the Spirit, let us also follow the Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Those who follow you, Lord,
will have the light of life. Bless the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on his law day and night. Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life. He is like a tree planted near running water that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves never fade. whatever he does prospers.
Those who follow me, Lord, will have the light of life.
Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff, which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Those who follow me, Lord, will have the light of life.
Alleluia.
Scholars of the law said to him in reply, "Teacher, by saying this, you are insulting us too." And he said, "Woe to you, scholars of the law! You impose on people burdens hard to carry, but you yourselves do not lift one finger to touch them." The Gospel of the Lord. The works of the flesh, the fruits of the spirit. The first reading, very, very good reading, very important reading, very good reading for looking at decisions and affirming past decisions and looking at future decisions. Which is it that is operative when we make a decision? Is it the works of the flesh, the immorality, impurity, lrighteousness, idolatry, sorcery, hatreds, rivalry, jealousy, outbursts of fury, acts of selfishness, dissensions, factions, occasions of envy, drinking bouts, orgies, and the like. Take that on one hand, and on the other hand, you look at the fruits of the Spirit. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And so you hold those two things as you look at decisions. Say you were to move to a new town, you decided to take a new job and move to a new town far away and in wherever. Which one would it be feeding most? The works of the flesh? Is it going to increase immorality and hatred and rivalry and jealous and selfishness? Or is it going to build on love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control? If you were a college student making a college decision today, do you go to a party college? Or do you go to this other college? Which of these would be operative in those decisions? If you look back on your marriage decision, for those that are married, or a good friendship decision, which does that person in your life bring to you? And so we recognize Paul in a very direct way, laying out to the Galatians and to us a piece of deciding in life. And so we take a moment and recognize that operation, but also recognize that choosing faith and choosing Christ and it brings us to those fruits of the Spirit. When we're walking in that, we're feeling and knowing. Or when we're deciding and we can see these fruits active, we know we're walking in the right way or making the right decision. So let us either ponder a past decision or look forward to a future decision and ask ourselves, was the fruit of the Spirit active? The love, the joy, the peace, the patience, the kindness, the generosity, the faithfulness, the gentleness, and self-control. us lift up our prayers and these prayers spoken to our Lord.
For the church, may the Holy Spirit animate each of the members with new joy and zeal for Christ's mission. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in authority, may God give them the grace of humility. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those burdened by poverty, hopelessness, or sickness, may God give them peace and provide relief for their burdens. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the community gathered here, may God preserve us in harmony and humility through the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Steve Sanders, may they find endless joy and love and peace in God's embrace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray for an end to this pandemic, for a cure to COVID-19, for healing for those who are sick, and safety for our many healthcare workers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
let us pray for the big decisions in our life and the lives of our loved ones, that they may truly choose decisions that rest in the fruits of the Spirit. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
together we pray the intercession of St. Joseph. Good St. Joseph, as you led the Holy Family, watch over our families. Help our family and all families to know and share God's love. In our family relationships, may we find healing and seek to be holy. May our fathers help us to become faithful disciples of Jesus, who share our love for him. As foster father of Jesus, watch over all who serve as spiritual fathers. In a special way, bless our Holy Father, our bishop, and our priests. May they follow your humble example in their fatherly care for the people of God and the church. With Mary, you raised Jesus the high priest. You know our need for priests. Please raise up good and holy priests from our families to serve the people of our diocese. May our children and grandchildren hear and say yes to the call of Jesus, just as you and Mary did. Good St. Joseph, pray for us. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands. It should become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It should become for us our spiritual. Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Accept this sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honor of blessed Callistus a means of to our eternal salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith, to their endurance you grant firm resolve, and in their struggle the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim, Holy. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with the martyr Saint Callistus, with the saints, especially Saint Francis of Assisi, who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him. God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. The Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I give you. Peace peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let's acknowledge one another with a sign. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Behold. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper.
Please pray with us now the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
us pray. May the sacraments we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which blessed Callistus burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Now thank we our God with hearts and
hands
and voices, who wondrous things has done, in whom this world rejoices, who from our mother's arms has blessed us on our way with countless gifts of love and sin.